Please see the link in the description to download a worksheet for this video. Experiments can be dangerous. If you are a child, never do experiments unless your parent, guardian, or adult educator says it's all right and is there with you the whole time. When geologists are in fields or elsewhere in nature, they may come across a rock and want to know what it is. One of the tools they can use to identify a rock is called the Mohs Hardness Scale, which is a scale of 10 naturally occurring rocks. This is a typical kit, except a kit usually does not include the 10th item, because that is a diamond and can be expensive. The rocks on the Mohs Hardness Scale are all minerals, which means they were made in nature and are pure crystals. These are some common crystals in nature, which can be alone or inside of the rocks. Each of these 10 minerals has a different level of hardness, so we can put them in order from least hard, which has a value of 1, to hardest, which has a value of 10. Although few people memorize all the names and their numbers, most students remember that talc is the softest mineral in the Mohs Hardness Scale, and diamonds are the hardest mineral in the Mohs Hardness Scale. We'll show pictures of each of these as a large crystal. Number 1 is talc. Number 2 is gypsum. Number 3 is calcite. Number 4 is fluorite. Number 5 is apatite. Number 6 is orthoclase feldspar. Number 7 is quartz. Number 8 is topaz. Number 9 is corundum. Number 10 is diamond. We are more familiar with diamonds that look like this, which have been cut and polished. But here is a rough diamond as it is found in nature. Using this kit, we can test any object and estimate how hard it is. We'll show 3 examples. This coaster is made of a rock called slate. We'll start with the 5th hardest mineral, which is apatite. We pull the apatite across the slate, and it leaves a scratch. That tells us that the apatite is hard on the slate. Next, we try the 4th hardest mineral, which is fluorite. Likewise, fluorite also leaves a scratch, so we know that fluorite is harder than the slate. Next, we try calcite. This time, we see a large white mark, but we can easily brush it away. So that mark was due to calcite crumbling. This means the slate is harder than calcite. So the Mohs Hardness Scale value for the slate is between 3 and 4. Let's try bold. We start with the 5th hardest mineral, which is apatite. It cannot scratch the bold, so that means the bold is harder than the apatite. Next, we'll try orthoclase feldspar. Likewise, we find it also cannot scratch the bold. To confirm, we use a fingernail to feel for a scratch and cannot feel one. So the bold is harder than a value of 6. We continue to go up the scale and now try quartz. This time we see and feel a scratch, which tells us the quartz is harder than the bold. That means the Mohs Hardness Scale value for the bold is between a 6 and a 7. For our last example, we'll test this wax candle. As before, we start with apatite, and it easily scratches the candle. Then we try fluorite, and it also scratches the candle. Next, we try calcite, and it scratches the candle too. Now we try gypsum, and it scratches the candle. Finally, we try talc, and it also scratches the candle. This tells us that the talc is harder than the wax candle, so the candle has a Mohs Hardness Scale value of less than 1. Since there are no negative numbers on the Mohs Hardness Scale, the candle has a value that is between 0 and 1. The Mohs Hardness Scale was invented more than 200 years ago, so is very famous, and is a convenient way to compare the hardness of things with an inexpensive kit. But to get more accurate measurements of how hard something is, we use a different machine such as this one. A problem with the Mohs Hardness Scale is that the actual hardness between neighboring minerals differs a lot. Some steps are small and some steps are large. Since all the step sizes are different, it is difficult for us to quickly calculate how much harder one object is than another object. This is in contrast to how most of our measuring tools work, such as a metric ruler, in which the step sizes, which are all just 1 centimeter, are equal size. For example, if you have a blue block that is 6 centimeters tall, then you know it is twice as tall as a green block that is 3 centimeters tall. And you also know that the blue block is 6 times as tall as the red block, that is 1 centimeter tall. In contrast with the Mohs Hardness Scale, if someone tells you that an object has a Mohs value of 6, then that object is 7 times harder than an object with a Mohs value of 3. This surprises some people to assume that an object with a Mohs value of 6 would be 2 times as hard as an object with a Mohs value of 3. And that object is also 331 times harder than an object with a Mohs value of 1. That's a much bigger number than being 6 times harder, as some people might assume when comparing values on the scale. Nevertheless, Mohs Hardness Scale is well known, so it is good to be familiar with how to use it. Knowing what materials are harder than others is important when engineers design tools, and when people are choosing what tools to use for their jobs. For example, this drill bit can cut through steel, because the drill bit is made of a harder material than the block of metal that it is drilling holes into. These drill bits are coated in small diamonds, so they can drill through any stone. This bridge saw can cut through any stone, because it is made with a metal saw blade that has many tiny diamonds attached to it. It's the diamonds that are cutting the stone, not the metal blade. We have to use diamonds to cut the stones because, as we demonstrated in the experiment with the bolt, many stones are harder than metal. Here's a summary of the topic we just covered. Please pause the video to read this if you wish. If you're interested in practice tests that are similar to state exams, but with detailed, colorful explanations for each answer, then please see our apps in the App Store. Many of these are free and none expire or limit their function. Since we only make educational products for children, none of our apps have third-party advertising, in-app purchasing, or connect to the internet. Please subscribe if you'd like to be notified of future educational videos we make. Thanks for your attention.